space is big. The galaxy is pretty big too. If you can believe it, there are probably over 2 dozen planets in the galaxy alone. And don't even get me started. The universe itself? Definitely way over 4 dozen. Stars too. We got a lot of those. You know, it's a big place out there.
And now that the fish is in the pan and seasoned to taste, you're going to want to retrieve your ancestral blade from the corpse of your arch nemesis. If you can't find your own ancestral blade, store-bought is fine too.
Alright, back to you, Bob. Thanks, Michael. Where am I?
So, just what happened to the YouTuber exactly? Well, many have their theories, but one through line remains consistent. He hasn't uploaded in almost a year. This evening, we'll be delving down the rabbit hole and taking a look at the details behind his disappearance. This is a pretty involved start to what should be a straightforward video. Hello again, everyone. Long time no see. How are the kids, the wife, the house, the job, all things I'm sure I've missed in my absence. Now, I've never liked making videos to inform about real-world goings-ons. I've always entrusted that to other websites. But seeing as, again, it's been nearly a year since I've uploaded last, I figured I should make a video telling about just what I've been up to and why I haven't made a video since the big one. So, let's start things off and roll the clock back about 13 months. This is me, sitting in my room, dinking about, when suddenly, an idea hits me. I'm gonna make a crazy big video, the biggest I've ever made, a sort of season finale for my main series, Monsters Misguided. I write a script, hire some voice actors, and draw some frames. And 2 months or so later, voila, it's done. That's the short version. All the details are there though, the ones that matter at least. So, question one, why the break? To make it short? Because this project killed my drawing hand. It was the first time a drawing project actually caused me physical damage that required me to step back from my job, and also my hobby, and just chill out for a while. Took about 2 months to recover to a comfortable level, and then a few months more to get back to absolute normal, which is admittedly generous, since now, even writing this script, my hand cramps and aches as it did right after finishing the video. Why did this happen? I bit off a lot, to be sure, but the amount of work needed to be put into the video wasn't as much of a problem as the time frame I gave myself was. I was doing a minute of video every day until it was finished, with a total of about 2.5 days off, if I'm remembering correctly. That isn't good, if it isn't clear already, that's bad, and what's worse is that I was no different than my usual intensity of work on other videos, it was just over a longer period. Back a while, I got it stuck in my head that in order to make it on YouTube, I need to upload constantly. That isn't really anything I made up, that's just true, but it got to me. Unfortunately, that doesn't work out so well if you have to hand draw every second of the videos you make. Me, being the absolute fool I am, I didn't put that together, and instead, I tried to work with the algorithm's specifications. Long story short, you know, too much drawing too frequently, hand go ouchie. Big mistake. Question 2. Why didn't I come back after I was into the green zone for drawing comfortably? Well, to be honest, the last video burnt me out mentally too. It was a lot of work, and by the time I was done with it, I'd realized 2 big things. I enjoyed the process the most, as it was a video made outside my usual tell a story, spit out some numbers in the middle format. It made me realize that I really only enjoyed the storytelling aspects of the videos. In that, I put together that the only reason I really made 2 separate series full of data and numbers and all of that stuff is because I figured that was the thing to do to make it on D&D YouTube. Everyone was doing it, why not me? To make a point, if I were to go back and do it again, I'd be a lot more light with the numbers, focusing more on the narrative part of the videos, as that's where my enjoyment and I think my strengths lie. And, you know, some may disagree, but up yours. The second half of this answer is about my own weird overworking mentality. The last video was big, very big, biggest I've ever made, almost half an hour long, fully voice acted, and consisting of over 300 unique drawings. So it's a big batch. Now, the issue with all of this was that it set a new bar in my brain. As silly as it sounds to say out loud, now meant that no matter what I did on the channel, I wouldn't be satisfied with the product unless it was at or above the level of that last one. Now, even I'm present enough in my own head to know that that, mixed with what the last video did to my hand, that's not a good combination. So I decided to take a longer break. And a longer one. Drawing just for myself and commissions, without the stress of keeping up with the uploads and concerning myself with how the numbers of each video are doing. It was pretty nice, and as it went on, that season finale video looked more like a series finale, and eventually, it kind of started to look like a channel finale, at least in my head. As time went on, I was seeing less and less reason and motivation within myself to continue doing videos. As I said, if I were to continue, they'd either be number-filled pieces or hand-destroying mini-movies.
I needed something else. Something that wouldn't cost me my hand with its workload, that would be fun to make, light or void of numbers and nerdy stuff, and it would have to be something that I'd be able to improve in and set reasonable new bars for myself with. All signs pointed towards a comic. So that's what I did. In about December of last year, I started working on a new comic. I finally found something to do regularly that wouldn't fuck up my hand, something that I could release weekly, tell a story with, and generally have be a good old time. It was great. And then I drew a 42-page full-color prologue in 2 months, working all day, every day, and nearly ruined my hand again. Good God, I think I need to talk to somebody about this. I might have a problem. Very lucky for me, my hand didn't go into the same state of not being able to do anything at all that it did after the video was done. Yay. The comic is going strong as we speak, with 83 pages and counting, updating with 2 pages put out weekly. I'm very happy with it. If you're curious about it at all, here's a quick summary of what type of story to expect. By the Book is a brand new comic. No, I'm just kidding. By the Book is my new comic. That's what it's called. Set in the same universe as Monsters Misguided, just a bit later. It's an action mystery adventure about a tiefling detective named Penny. It's gonna have shonen and magical girl elements, horror elements, cosmic and otherwise, espionage and gothic literature influences. It's got a lot already and will have much more. So if any of that interests you, go give it a read for me. There should be some art up on the screen right now to give you a flavor, taste of what to expect going in. It'd be super helpful if you gave it a read and shared it around. It's my flagship project right now. One big thing I got going on, like Monsters Misguided was back in ye olden days. You can read it on my Patreon in high res for free, mind you, the pages are public. You can also read it in long scrolling form for phones and whatnot on a tap ass. So yeah, that's that. Enough of a plug. While I'm burnt out on videos in general, I've been thinking about making an audio motion comic of By the Book's prologue, complete with voice actors and narration, so if that sounds interesting, let me know. The drawings for it are all already done, so it wouldn't be a totally foolish undertaking. That's about the long and short of what's been going on. This entire time, I've probably been too active on Twitter, drawing frequently and chit-chatting, so if any of this or that interests you, drop a follow and keep up to date. I also sell art packs, you've probably seen a couple of them from the community tab, yada yada, if that interests you, you get the idea. Also, this video isn't to say I'm never gonna make a video again. This whole little jaunt between the channel and comic has made me realize thinking in terms of forever like that never really works out. As I said, I might come back with a voice-acted version of my comic's prologue, and now that Critical Role is done with its second season, and I'm very bummed out about that, I might come back with an animatic sometime to, just to remember it by. I love those characters so much, man. Back on track. This video is more to say this channel has entered and will continue a sort of extended hibernation while I explore other art/story outlets, ones that result in less physical injury, if I haven't made that clear by now. Reading this out, I can see how it could come off as dismissive and oh well, whatever, deal with it, in tone, but that might be because I came to terms with putting a period in things a while ago. I'm not really in the thinking things through stage at this point anymore. Bit of a bombshell to drop, I know, especially for those who are eagerly awaiting for the next installments of either series. Thank you for such fierce interest, and I'm sorry that I can't continue where you'd have hoped I did. Body and brain just can't handle it in the end, I guess. All in all, I'd like to thank everyone that made this channel what it is and has been and may continue to be. The videos are meant to be seen, so I appreciate all the people who've seen them, left likes and nice little comments, and of course, subscribed. Unfortunately, I just can't see myself doing it constantly forever as much as I once thought I could. But hey, things change and I'd rather get shit for appearing flaky with a little YouTube channel than force myself to do something I physically can't do. You know. So, that wraps things up for this video. Again, I'm not dead. Go follow me on Twitter for more art and updates on what's going on. Thanks for sticking to the end of this one, and I'll check y'all later.